So basically, we've decided that the Huawei P30 is the Donnie Wahlberg of the smartphone world. We love a bit of Donnie action, but let's face it, he's always going to be the other Wahlberg, living in the shadow of his younger, more famous sibling. Likewise, the P30 sports a brilliant tri-lens camera setup worthy of any flagship phone, but it does lack that main sexy headline-grabbing feature of its bigger bro, namely the 5x optical zoom. Regardless, I've really enjoyed wielding the Huawei P30 as my everyday camera phone for the last few days, and here is my in-depth Huawei P30 camera review to show you exactly how good it is for those photos and your home movies. And don't forget, for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech, to bog subscribe and ding that notifications bell. Cheers, everyone! So the first of those three aforementioned lenses is Huawei's all-new 40-megapixel super spectrum shooter with increased light sensitivity for more natural results and improved nighttime shooting. At least that's the theory. It is f1.8 and there's sadly no optical image stabilization, unlike on the Pro model. That's joined by a 16-megapixel ultra-wide-angle lens, while the final shooter is an 8-megapixel telephoto lens which sports that new funky periscope design. However, it is, of course, as mentioned, a 3x optical zoom instead of the full fat 5x zoom of the P30 Pro. Now jump on into the camera app and you might possibly feel slightly overwhelmed by all the various modes and toggles, especially if you've never used a Huawei phone before. But never fear, because the P30 works well on full auto mode. The Master AI can now be switched on or off directly from the main UI as well, instead of fiddling about in the bloody settings, which is an absolute blessing. Here on the P30, that AI feature doesn't seem to have quite as strong an effect as it did on the Pro model, but it can still help to highlight certain colours, such as those lush greens when you're capturing a landscape. And it also automatically switches you to the likes of portrait mode when it recognises you're shooting a fellow human being, or night mode when things get pretty dark. This swapping works perfectly well, saving you from having to manually flip about through all the various modes. We were more than happy with our everyday shots, which boast strong detail levels. The P30 shoots at 10 megapixel by default, and that's fine for enjoying a bit of slideshow action on your telly. With the AI mode deactivated, Huawei's handset captures accurate colours too, for a natural, realistic finish. Which outcome you'll prefer is completely down to your own personal taste, but we mostly kept the Master AI switched on for these shots. HDR situations are certainly well handled, with only the occasional test shot slightly marred by a whitewashed appearance. And even then, they were still perfectly fine for sticking in a digital album. You tend to get strong detailing in those darker areas, while bright skies and other strong light sources are rarely overblown. However, it is once again those low light situations where Huawei's phone is the don. Flick on the P30's long exposure night mode and you get bright, beautifully balanced photos, no matter what you're trying to shoot. There's simply nothing better around right now, although the likes of Google's night mode on the Pixel 3 phones isn't too far off. Of course, the Pro model does capture slightly more natural colours than the standard P30 in low light, thanks to its wider aperture. You can switch to the ultra-wide or telephoto views at any point, so the P30 is perfectly flexible to suit any situation. That ultra-wide shooter is our favourite for capturing dramatic shots of touristy hotspots. You can get some gorgeous looking results without too much of a warp effect. However, the telephoto lens is even more of a superstar. You don't get that crazy bonkers 10x lossless hybrid zoom of the Pro model, but the Huawei P30 can still grab sharp shots at that 5x hybrid level, which is better than most flagship rivals and fine for grabbing funky architecture shots or snapping any cats that happen to venture into your garden. On the video front, there's no difference here from the P30 Pro. You can capture footage at up to 4K resolution at 30 frames per second, or bump up to 60fps at that full HD resolution. There's sadly no 4K 60fps option, and nor does the P30 offer up an HDR shooting mode. Compared with rivals such as the Galaxy S10, the video options are definitely limited, but thankfully our test clips all came out nicely. We didn't notice any issues even when shooting Ultra HD video, and the image stabilization is pretty smooth at that top detail setting. That said, the color temperature at 4K is rather warm, certainly compared with rival handsets. And that's with the standard colours mode too. It's not necessarily better or worse, that's all just down to personal preference, of course. And at night, sadly, the P30 doesn't impress as much as it does for photos. You can expect typically grainy looking footage, like with most rival handsets. Flip to the front of the P30 and you get a 32 megapixel upgraded lens with f2.0 aperture. As usual, this does a bang-up job, delivering strong detail and impressive portrait results too, despite the lack of a dedicated depth sensor. It's not as strong at night as the rear camera, as there's no long exposure option, but our test shots were still sharp and relatively bright. Unlike the full-on Pro model, you can shoot up to full HD resolution video using the Huawei P30's front-facing snapper. No 4K option, sadly. The results are absolutely fine, just basically what you would expect. So right there is what we think of the Huawei P30's camera tech after a few days of testing. Stay tuned for our in-depth P30 and P30 Pro review to see what we think of the rest of Huawei's latest flagship phones. And don't forget to poke, subscribe, and ding that notifications bell to be the first to see when that shiz goes live. Cheers, everyone. Love you.